Yes, good morning everyone. I am Paweł Konczewski, and with my wife Magdalena, we represent teams of science in Wrocław universities and another institution from Poland, researchers of the cultural and natural heritage of woodlands. Our team consists of archaeologists, for example, Piotr Wroniecki, anthropologists, botanics, and zoologists, and colleagues from forest management. The area of our interest are the woods of the Central European Lowlands. Science, beginning of the Pleistocene, they have created a specific living condition for humans. The inhabitants, because of environmental aspects, of based most of the economy on the exploitation of the woods. Some of the forms of these activities are still visible in the landscapes and ecosystems. But not all them. While many of them left traces that could be identified through archaeological research, some still remains alive to use. Beekeeping is one of the best examples. Lower Silesian Wilderness consists many representative examples of discussed species. It is located in southwestern Poland, and it is the largest continuous forest on the country and one of the largest in Central Europe. The archaeological research shows that the area was inhabited by with a different intensity science the Mesolithic period until today. This can be pointed out as the main reasons of changes visible in nature environment. Recent studies allow now to create a description of many traces of anthropopressure. This area has been penetrated by human science at the beginning of Holocene. From the Bronze Age, we know the settlements and extensive cemeteries operating from the third period of the Bronze Age to the end of Hallstatt period. The rapid development and increase of numbers of settlements is visible in the early Iron Age. It was connected to the fortified settlements of the Urnfield tradition. The collapse came in the 5th century BC when the Scythians' attacks overlaid the climate changes. The recolonization takes place in the late Roman period, with the appearance of Germanic Burgundians. In the 8th century, regions become a home for Slavs. They form two distinct settlements enclaves, north and south on the Lower Silesian Wilderness, but forest themselves remain anecumene. This changes during the late Middle Ages. The growth continues until the 30 Years' War, which resulted in war damages and depopulation of settlements. The situation repeated during time before and after Second World War. Numerous settlements were quickly absorbed by the nature. The effect of this it can be seen in the improvement of the local phytocenosis. We know that because of the hunting in recent centuries, bears, lynx, and wolves have disappeared from the area of the Lower Silesian Wilderness. During our research, we came across trapping pits used to catch them, so-called wolf pits. The digging of wolf pits was forbidden in the 18th century, due to the fact that other animals and humans also fell into it. Despite this, wolves were finally exterminated in the 19th century with the use of firearms. In recent years, wolves have repeated in the Lower Silesian Wilderness, which is a manifestation of their return to ecological balance. During our prospection, we found many arrowheads and bullets for firearms, but the context of discoveries is not allowed to be identified as relics of hunting. For the most part, they are most likely related to the military conflicts taking place in these woods. The most significant anthropogenic changes are connected to the vegetation of the discussed forest. Palynological research indicated that originally it was a mixed forest. Pines consisted up to 70% with the addition of oaks, beeches and ash trees. Currently, over 95% they are pine monocultures. Our research shows that first small-scale deforestation happened in the early Iron Age. This process intensified during the Roman period. It was related to the production of iron, for which few amounts of charcoal created from locally wood. The scale of this process in the second and third centuries led to a local ecological disasters. The activation of the Aeolian process and buried one of the settlements under the sand. With time, as a result of the succession of secondary vegetation, the forest was reborn. It was again cut in the late Middle Age, when the village of Tormersdorf was established here. Part of this village was afforested in the first half of the 19th century. This planned afforestation was then an innovative method of forest management. The production of charcoal on much larger scale started in the late Middle Age and later. Devastation of forests was so huge that in the first half of the 18th century, this procedure was banned. However, locally charcoal was fired until the beginning of the 20th century. Geophysical and survey research indicates that the pines visible in the landscapes are probably the youngest one. Below them, we have usually found remains of older pines that show the actual scale of charcoal production. Only in one part of the researched area of 0.2 square kilometers, we have registered a list of 14 charcoal pines. The production of iron, glass and ceramics involved the extraction of necessary mineral sources. During our research, we have focused so far on iron smelting, among other things at the banks of Cherna River in the vicinity of the deserted village Neuhaus. So we have identified areas where bog iron was excavated. Of course, we cannot underestimate of importance of water. From the Middle Ages, the water wells provided energy for all kinds of mice. Of course, grist mice and hammer mice forges, fueling mice and paper mice. Only in the western part of Lower Silesia Wilderness, we have identified relics of more than 40 workshops. Unfortunately, most of the near located fish ponds connected to another form of river exploitation currently have dried out, but are still visible, just like this. That what has brought people to Lower Silesian Wilderness was for sure an easy access to resources needed to in iron production. The three of four of them wood, iron, and water even today are easy to get, but the last one, clay, not so much. Needed especially the Iron Age of, to build of blameries. Its deposits could easily to be exploited only some in the places of river valleys, just like this on the Nisa Valley. The meteorological complex from the late Middle Age was discovered in the village Neuhaus. In the addition to traces of bog iron or exploitation, we have located area of its pretreatments and two areas that served as forges. The forge visible at the picture, burned in the first half of 17th century, most likely during the 30 Years' War, and it has been never rebuilt. The given examples of exploitation of forest ecosystems in the Lower Silesia Wilderness constitute only a small fragment of archaeological heritage. This forest or are almost saturated with the traces of former human activities. I think this is a special area in Poland where cultural heritage creates a conglomerate with a natural one. That's why as a team we have decided that only an interdisciplinary approach will result in providing a full-scale image of people trying to base their existence for forest exploitation. And thanks to this, we can identify ecological anomalies that lead used to their anthropogenic origin. This may herald a better understanding above all protection for heritage hidden and protection heritage hidden between trees. For more information, visit our website. And I think it is all. Thank you for your attention.